Hello, in this video, I'm going to be talking about exemestane. Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to our channel. We're always putting out new material, often in response to your comments or questions. So what is exemestane? Exemestane is an aromatase inhibitor. It's similar to letrozole and anastrozole in the way it works. What exemestane does is it blocks the aromatase enzyme. The aromatase enzyme is responsible for converting, basically I'm going to call them male sex hormones, to estrogen in the body of people who have the aromatase enzyme. Actually, everybody does, but in women, this is the enzyme responsible for converting testosterone family of drugs, of hormones, into estrogen. By blocking the enzyme that does that conversion, it lowers estrogen in the body of people with no ovarian production of estrogen after menopause or after surgical menopause. So exemestane will block the production of estrogen in the body made in other parts of the body other than the ovaries, specifically the fat, the adrenal glands, the breast tissue itself, and lower estrogen in your body. If you have ovaries, the ovaries make so much estrogen that exemestane can't shut it down. So we only use this drug in people who no longer have ovarian function by whatever means, whether it's with time, with surgery, with radiation, or with injections. All three aromatase inhibitors are highly effective in preventing breast cancer from coming back after an initial diagnosis, surgery, and other treatments, and in people who have advanced disease where cancer has spread to other parts of the body. If you're wondering if exemestane or one of the other aromatase inhibitors is part of your treatment plan, I would love to invite you to go to yerbba.com and get your personalized Yerbba report. Your Yerbba report, after you give us permission, will download your medical records, go through that, compile everything for you, create a report specific to you, then cross-reference all the characteristics of you as a person and your tumor characteristics with the current medical research and tell you things, the options you might be offered when you see your medical team. There are a couple differences about exemestane. It is a irreversible steroidal aromatase inhibitor. Letrozole and anastrozole are temporary inhibitors of the enzyme, and they are non-steroidal. We thought, when we first started studying exemestane, that it had some protective effects on the bone. We thought it was much less likely to lead to loss of bone mineral density. We also thought that it might be more effective than letrozole or anastrozole, and it turns out that none of that's true. Basically, those are all comparable. The one thing to know is that in people on the other aromatase inhibitors, like letrozole and anastrozole, if their cancer progresses, approximately 1 in 5 people would have a benefit of exemestane. So there's some non-cross resistance there. And before we had all the other options that we have, that was a common strategy. Exemestane can be combined with other therapies as well, like everolimus, which is a chemo drug, but in general, it's given on its own. It can be given after tamoxifen or in place of, instead of tamoxifen. And any of these options is very reasonable with very similar outcomes. So if a 5-year course of endocrine therapy is what is being recommended, you might start on tamoxifen and switch to exemestane, or you might start on exemestane and switch to tamoxifen. Or you can switch to exemestane after 5 years of tamoxifen. One of the things you may find is that people who are having a lot of symptoms on letrozole or anastrozole, who've been through one or the other, if you're really having a lot of symptoms, exemestane could be an option for you and you may tolerate that much better. These are very effective drugs, and again, there's no drug that's superior to another. So if you've been on letrozole and you're doing well, stay on letrozole. If you're on anastrozole and doing well, stay on it. You don't need to switch, and if you're on exemestane, you don't need to switch. Some insurance companies will only cover one or the other, and that's certainly well-founded. There's no reason. They may have an arrangement with a pharmaceutical company and be able to get in much better prices for one drug or the other. That's called the formulary. So the drugs that they carry may differ or cover may differ according to your insurance company. And I have no concerns about that unless you're not tolerating it. Then they'll often make an exception unless you take a different aromatase inhibitor. Let's talk about side effects. These are very similar to the other aromatase inhibitors. The most common side effects are hot flashes, joint aches and pains. Your cholesterol may go up a little bit. Some people see their blood pressure go up a little bit. Bone thinning is a concern because we're shutting down estrogen in your body and our bones love estrogen. So these are all concerns that you might have. You might have some leg cramps. Any of these side effects can be managed and tend to get worse in the beginning and then they may get better. If at 3 months they're still there, you may want to switch to a different one. Other side effects are related to lower estrogen in the body, like thinning of the hair, or thinning of the skin. All these are reversible when you come off exemestane or any of the aromatase inhibitors. I hope this has been helpful. We do have another video on side effects of the aromatase inhibitors you might want to check out and how to manage some of those. Drop comments or questions below. We get back to you within a couple weeks. And as always, thank you for watching.